Before developing a project, installing software, or even laying out functionality, it's necessary to take stock of the hardware you will be communicating to. The available hardware will determine your licensing requirements, server specifications, and of course, what type of data will be available to the software. You may already have some type of device address list provided by your IT department, but I prefer a graphical network diagram so I can see how the equipment interconnects. This is especially useful in troubleshooting, as I can quickly determine if I've had a device failure or a gateway failure. There are several pieces of information to include on a network diagram. Naturally, you'll want the device name and type. You may also want to group devices together, possibly by panel, switchgear, area, or building. This naming hierarchy will help us later when we build our equipment names in the database. Next, the server fundamentally communicates over an Ethernet network, so every device connected to the network will need an IP address. You may also want to show the network hardware, like switches, routers, and cable or fiber type. For our purposes, it only matters that we know the IP address and that it can be reached from the server. Some devices may not connect directly to the Ethernet network, but rather through a gateway device. These may be serial daisy chains, data concentrators, or network isolators. You'll want to include this information on the diagram, as well as any configuration options to help you troubleshoot later, like baud rate and parity. You may also want to include the protocol on the network diagram. We can support a large number of communication protocols, like IEC 61850, Modbus, DNP, and SNMP. The list of supported protocols is always growing, so I'll refer you to the System Guide section called Connected Devices and Protocols. Related to this, some communication protocols will require additional information to be laid out. For example, serial Modbus devices will need a Modbus address. BACnet devices all have unique BACnet IDs. And serial devices will have MAC addresses. This type of information is critical to the network diagram, as we'll use that to address devices in the project. At this point, each device should have a name, type, and address, whatever that entails, which will go into the project database. You'll also want a count of how many devices of each type are in the network. This will help us in selecting a license, which is our next video. Until then, thank you.